Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular Gantt chart component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Gantt package. I will also show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like setting timeline views and task dependencies. The Angular Gantt chart is a project planning and management tool used to display and manage hierarchical tasks with timeline details. It helps assess how long a project should take, determine the resources needed, manage the dependencies between tasks, and plan the order in which the tasks should be completed. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create my application using the Angular CLI command. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In the command prompt, I install the CLI tool globally using the npm install global Angular CLI command. Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I navigate to the desired location and install the Gantt chart package using the ng add syncfusion ej2 Angular Gantt command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the Gantt chart component, I navigate to the app module page and import the Gantt module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Gantt package. I register it in the imports array of the ng module. After that, I import the material theme styles to the style.css file to apply styles to the Gantt chart component. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. I open the main TypeScript file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license. Starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release, the license key is mandatory for Angular projects to avoid a licensing warning. In the app.component.html file, I replace the default code snippets with the Angular Gantt chart component using the ejsGantt tag. Then I set the height property value to 490 pixels. Let's see how to bind data to the Gantt chart. In the data.js file, I have defined the object project new data with a collection of tasks. To a single task, I have added fields like task ID, task name, and so on. I have also added the subtasks field to define the child tasks. I have added other tasks as well, with appropriate parent and subtasks. Now I'm going to bind this complex data to the Gantt chart component. Within the app component class, I import the project new data and assign it to the public variable data. In the app-component.html page, I assign that project data to the datasource property of the Gantt chart component. Then I must map the necessary datasource fields to find the project task values using the task fields property. Within the app-component class, I declare a variable task settings and map datasource fields to the task values such as ID, name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. At last, I map the subtasks field from datasource to the child property. Then I assign this variable to the task fields property. Let me run this application. See here, the left pane has a tree grid, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline to represent the project duration as individual cells with defined units and formats. And when I collapse or expand the child records, it will be reflected in the timeline. The Gantt chart component has different built-in timeline views: hour, day, week, month, and year. Look here, the week timeline mode has the upper part of the header displaying the weeks, whereas the bottom half of the header displays the days. To change the timeline view, add the timeline settings property. Within the app component class, I declare a variable timeline view and set the timeline view mode property value to day. Then I assign this variable to the timeline settings property. And now the day timeline mode is rendered in Gantt chart. The upper part of the header displays the days, and the bottom header displays their corresponding hours. I can customize the column name and display selective columns in the Gantt chart component using the columns property. Within the app component class, I declare the object, column settings, and include the field property to map the task ID field from the data source. I add the header text property to provide a custom header and set its value to task ID. In the same way, I map the other column's task name, start date, and duration using the field property. I have more options to customize the Gantt columns, of which I will show you the basic options now. I change the default date format in the short date column by setting the format property value to custom day, month, and year. For the duration column, I align its content by setting the text-align property value to write. Then I assign this variable to the columns property. I comment out the timeline settings to display the default timeline view. Checking the Gantt chart, only the specified columns in the columns directive tag are shown. Notice that the customized header is shown in the task ID column. The custom date format was applied to the short date column. And the duration column text is right aligned. Finally, I will show you how to show a task dependency in the timeline. The available types are start to start, start to finish, finish to start, finish to finish. Notice that the task 4 predecessor is set to task 2. Within the app component class, I add the dependency property in the task field settings and map the predecessor field from data source. As you can see, task 2 is a dependent of task 4. And I cannot start task 4 until the dependent task 2 is completed. In this video, I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion Angular Gantt chart component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Gantt package. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like setting timeline views and task dependencies. You can download the working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.